Hi, co-tutor here. My name is Anil Deshpande. I am the co-author of Composing Mobile Apps. In the previous video, we had seen how an intent works. In this case, we will continue to go further in the concept of intents, and we will see how the implicit intents work. As the name itself indicates, in the implicit intents, we don't mention the name of the Android component that we want to trigger. So how does the identification of the component that needs to be triggered happens? The component that needs to be triggered is resolved through a concept of intent filter. As in the diagram depicted here, assume that I have a component one, which could be an activity, service, or a broadcast receiver, and I want to trigger component two. In the explicit intent, component one explicitly mentions another component, that is component 2, that it wants to trigger. But in the case of intent filter, what happens is component 1 will broadcast an intent. Then that intent is allowed to be handled by the Android system. Through the intent filter, the Android system finally identifies the other component that needs to be triggered. Let us now understand what actually intent filter means. Any component that needs to be triggered through the implicit intent has to declare certain set of attributes on which it wants to respond. This is done through the intent filter tag. When I declare an activity, service, or broadcast receiver that needs to be triggered through an intent filter, in the manifest file, I will be writing an intent filter tag. And this intent filter tag basically contains three further attributes. One is action, another one is category, and the third one is data. This particular component, which is declared in the manifest file with the intent filter, will only respond if an intent happens in the application with the matching intent filter. But there are certain set of rules to be followed when a perfect match is considered for the intent resolution. So when an intent is triggered, its action, category, and data are compared against declarations present in the intent filter. The correct match would be the action of the intent should match at least one of the action present intent filter. This is so because an intent filter can contain multiple action declarations. So that is why at least one of the action by the intent should match with. So when an intent is triggered with the action value, it should match with at least one of the action value that has been declared in the intent filter tags of the manifest file. The next attribute that needs to match are category. The category of the intent should match all the categories present in the intent filter. And then the third part, that is data. The data of the intent should match with the data of the intent present in the intent filter. Let us try to understand this through a demo. In the previous case, we have seen that I have an activity which triggers another activity through a explicit intent. You can see that I have explicitly mentioned activity second dot class, which is another activity that is declared in the manifest file. On click of that particular button, the triggering of the second activity is happening. What we will do now is we will remove the explicit intent and then we will make use of implicit intent to make this work. So let me comment it out, this particular part of the code, and then I will create a intent. Then to the intent I need to set the action and the category. So you can see that intent has got two methods. One is add category and set action. So let me set a action com dot, it could be any string data that you can set here. So com dot sample dot intent, let this be the action value. Then I will set intent dot add category, use a default category. It is a declared value that is present in the intent. You can make use of other categories as well if at all you have any custom categories, but for simplicity purpose I have chosen this particular one. And then I will go to the manifest file. In this particular manifest file I will have to write the intent filter. The new tag that I need to create is intent filter, and then the action. The value of the action should match what I am setting in the intent in the main activity. So let me copy this particular value so that it perfectly matches when the intent gets triggered with this particular string value. And then I need to set the category. I will use the default category. The activity has been declared in the manifest file with the action and category, and the intent has also been set with the same action and category. Now it is all matter of starting that particular activity. But you can observe the main difference between this particular code that we had commented out is, in this we had explicitly mentioned the activity that I want to trigger, but in this case I am not mentioning the name of the activity that I want to trigger. I am just mentioning the action and category, and I will pass that particular intent. And when the intent gets triggered, what Android system will do is, it will compare the action and category values that I have set in the intent that is getting triggered with the intent filter declarations in that particular app. And if they match, it will trigger that particular activity. So let us see whether it will trigger the second activity now. Activity has started. Click. You can see that the second activity is getting triggered, even though that I have not mentioned which particular activity that I want to trigger. So this is a very important concept in Android, that is ability to trigger components even without knowing the name of that particular component that I want to trigger. But what happens in case multiple components have same matching intent and intent filter declarations? And in such situations, app picker or a chooser will come. You might have encountered this situation when you want to share a particular picture, and when you click on the share icon in the app, it will open a window where it will show multiple apps from where you can choose a particular app to actually share a particular photo. In this case, what is happening is there are multiple components that have been declared in the manifest file to respond to the matching intent filter declarations. In that case, Android just allows the user to choose which one need to be finally resolved. This particular concept has been explained in a very detailed manner in the 5th chapter of Composing Mobile Apps, 5.7, Intent and Intent Resolution. We have tried to address this issue in a much more easily understandable manner. You can go through this particular chapter in our book. I have kept the code in the GitHub. You can download the code and start working with the code to understand how the overall execution works. Please leave your comments, any suggestions, or any more topics that you would like to see in this particular channel. Take care. Bye.